Hey. I'm still trying to get everything working, and I was having trouble with the audio. I was having trouble with everything, and I want to let you know that we should be live. If you'll let me know in the comments, if you can see me and hear me, that'd be great. Because I can't tell. I'm gonna double check the audio settings on this thing and see. Still not nothing. Let's see. Let's see. Okay, yeah, can you hear me and see me? Let me know if you're watching. I hear you but don't see you. You don't see me. That is crazy. Let's try something real quick. I'm gonna change cameras. This may change the view a little bit. I'm gonna go back. Okay, I got both. Tell me. Now, can you see me and hear me? I got a bunch of questions to go through tonight or today. And I want to make sure everybody can see me and hear me. Okay, I got a yes. All right, awesome. Awesome. Thanks for being here. We had an awesome show yesterday, and that was just cool. I'm going to I can hear and see you. Jim says I can hear and see you. Ben says he can hear and see me. Thank you. Thank y'all a bunch for letting me know. We were having problems at first. I'm moving my office and so it's a mess. You can tell behind me how messy it is. Let me get to the start of it. This is our every Friday Q&A session. You can ask questions about street food vending, catering, anything to do with street food vending, right? Hot dog vending, anything. And I'll try to get to all your questions. But today I have to tell you that we have a new thing we're starting where we're interviewing vendors, street food pros from Vendors United. Okay? We're interviewing them. And we have our first one today at 4 o'clock. So I've got to hurry. It's 3:32, right? It's 3:32 Eastern Standard. So here at 4 o'clock, I'll be interviewing a lady named Candace. If you'd like to ask her questions or talk to her, I'm going to be asking her tons of questions and talk about how she got started and everything. She just got started. We're going to talk about everything. She's one of the street food pros in the Vendors United group. Now, vendor of the week, though, congratulations to the dog father of Idaho Falls. Idaho Falls, out there where it's cold right now. Guarantee it's cold, right? The dog father of Idaho Falls. You can find him on Facebook, right here on Facebook, and just by putting in facebook.com/ dog father hot dogs all together. / dog father hot dogs. Congratulations to y'all. Thanks for being awesome. They serve hot dogs, brats, chili dogs, nachos, to all the Idaho Falls party goers every Thursday at Pepper Tree and at Karen's every Friday and Saturday. So 3 days a week. As I've told you before in my training, most vendors work 3 days a week, full-time vendors, 3 to 4. From R. Vinny Prescott. So this would be a good gig for a disabled veteran? Absolutely. We have tons of veterans. In fact, when I advertise something, guess what is the first thing I select when I advertise? Because Facebook has lookalike groups, okay? They'll find who your buyers are. They take your buyers and they look at it and they go, oh, that's this person, this type of person, or this occupation. Most of them disabled vets. We have tons of disabled vets. In fact, we have carts that help disabled vets. That's all they do. Okay. We've talked about them. We've got them that help police officers, fallen officer families. We've got them for dogs and cats and guinea pigs. So we've got a ton of different stuff available for you to go after. But I will tell you, absolutely, if you're a disabled vet, jump on it, okay? Jump on it. And if you will check with the American Disabilities Act, you probably can get in some places that nobody else can get into. So thank you for your service, though, by the way, Mr. Prescott. Do you have a spreadsheet on cost analysis for vendors? We have tons of that stuff in the form section over at Ben's Carts.com, accessories and stuff like that. There's a form section, and tons of stuff there. There's also tons of stuff over on the blog. And that's where I'd tell you to start. Go to the blog, learnhotdogs.com. And over on the search box, you'll see a search box on this side of the page, I think. When you're facing it, it's on your right. But you're looking at me, so it's over there. And it would be just type in spreadsheet, or type in daily sales, or sales form, or just form, and you'll pull up different ones that vendors have submitted. I've put on there that you can get and download. Thanks for the question though. John says, "Hey, can you go over bonding and insurance in one of your next videos, please?" Abso-freaking-lutely. This is my next video, so here you go, John. Bonding. Let's talk about that. Well, let's do this first. Let's talk about insurance first. There's two different insurance things, okay? There's your liability insurance, which covers you. Little Tommy doesn't listen to his mom, okay, and comes up and touches the side of your cart and burns his hand, and mom now wants to sue you, okay? Now, I've only heard of two incidents like this in all my years of vending. And not just me. I'm talking about all the vendors that I've dealt with, and that's over 16,000 vendors. Only twice have I heard of this. A suit, okay? If you have insurance, your insurance company has lawyers, and they take care of that for you. So I would get insurance. That's liability insurance. Over at learnhotdogs.com, on the side of the page, is a bunch of things. One of those things says insurance, and it's a big one. It says insurance, and it's the best deal we found. They don't pay me. I'm not endorsed or anything by them. I just know. In fact, we found out from a vendor about them. They're $299 a year. If you're a Vendors United member, you get it even cheaper. But $299 a year. I was paying $50 a month per cart, which is $600 a year, for less insurance. This gives you $1 million coverage per incident, but gives you up to two incidents per year. I've never heard of anybody needing it, but it looks good on paper, right? And if you did need it, it's there. Plus, they give you what they call an inland marine policy for $10,000 as a bonus, which covers like your laptop falls off your freaking cart or somebody walks by and steals it. It's an inland marine policy. We had one vendor that came on the radio show that used that actually. He had to use that insurance because he had an incident. Let's see. So that's normal insurance. Then you have the type of insurance that is for to cover, like you're towing your cart. That's car insurance. That's part of your car insurance. Call your car insurance agent. Say, hey, I'm going to be towing my cart behind my Harley or my Honda Goldwing or my Prius or my Toyota pickup like I do. And they will add it to your policy, covered anything that's legally towable, they'll cover. Usually it doesn't raise your insurance policy. Usually the good insurance companies don't even raise your policy to cover towed vehicles. They call it. Okay. So that's for, if somebody slams into you, okay, you can have full coverage or just liability, not the liability I was talking about a minute ago, just like car insurance liability, where somebody slams into you, their insurance pays it. Right. But if they didn't have insurance, if you had full coverage, your insurance would pay for it. I always go with liability on that side because I don't want to pay full coverage for that unless you were toting it with a brand new car, which you know, if you got a loan, you'd have to have full coverage anyway. It's probably covered. Just call your agent, find out. It's not a big deal. Okay. That's your two types of insurance. Now let's go over the bonding. What is bonding? Bonding is a way of securing or giving security to someone. Let me give you an example. I'm going to give you an unrelated example. I'm the electric company and you're fixing to go build a building and you're going to use a lot of electricity because it's 800,000 square feet of building. And I'm going to need to know that you can pay that bill every month on your electricity. You might not realize how expensive that building is going to be, heating and air and, you know, lights and all that stuff. Right. So I tell you, I want a bond issued by you to me for $10,000. Well, you can go to State Farm, okay? State Farm Insurance, get a bond for $10,000 for $50 a year. And you can have it assigned to whoever you want. So it could be assigned to the electric company. It could be assigned. It's basically in lieu of a deposit. Think of it like that. It's in lieu of a deposit, but you can get a bond for $1 million. You can get a bond for $100,000, but a bond is typically good for a year and it's a one-time fee. If you pay an annual fee and that's it, it's not a monthly payment deal. You have a bond for a year and that bond you can issue to someone, right? Now, let's say you're going to go do a big event and they want you bonded and insured. You've seen people like contractors say, we're bonded and insured. So they're insured and they're bonded. Almost ridiculous. You don't need to be both. But a bond allows them to, it requires less to get your money. So if you fail to pay your electric bill, all I got to do is call State Farm and go, yeah, I have a bond. I'm going to need that $6,200 he owes me for electric. And they just send it over. There's no claim filing. Okay. It's because I filed that because you didn't pay your electric bill. All I do is show, hey, you didn't pay it. Bond's over. Right. So that's what a bond is. And it helps you. It's a cheap way. It's an inexpensive way to give somebody a security, a feeling of security. Let's say you were trying to get a commissary. Okay. And I won't beat this to death, but I wanted to cover it carefully. But let's say you're getting a commissary and you're going to use Bubba's Barbecue as your commissary. And they go, well, we want you to be bonded and list us as the insured. So you just go get a bond for $50, 10,000 insurance, right? And you list Bubba's Barbecue on it. You're done. No insurance policy, no big hoopla to go through. It's just simple. It's instant and it's bam. Some insurance companies do them, issue them online. You just fill it out, pay the $50, done, gone. It gives them the security to know, let's say they gave you a key to their building. Bubba's Barbecue gave you a key to their building so that you can go there at 2 a.m. on Saturday after you worked at Tommy's Bar, okay, serving weenies, and you get to the commissary or your employee gets to the commissary, ransacks the place. Bubba's Barbecue can go, oh, I got a bond on him. I can file it right now. Done. They get their money. Everybody's done. They can tell you to go take a hike because you let some crazy person into their restaurant who didn't take care of it. That's what a bond's for. Just it's an easy way to get insurance, right? So, or a security note. Next question from Amber. Looking for reasonable priced hot dog carts for sale. If you have any idea for any on that are available, please contact me. Thanks in advance. Amber. This is a good question. I have blog articles on where to find good carts. In my most basic training, which is my quick step training, which is free at learnhotdogs.com, top of the page, start here, it says, and then it says free training. Okay, go there. And I think it's the fourth or fifth video down. I actually think it's the third and fifth video because one covers used carts and one covers finding carts, any carts, and how to find the best deals on carts, right? So that goes through that. Learnhotdogs.com is going to find anything you can imagine if you need help with something. But that's where I would go, and I'll walk you step by step on the ways to find a used cart, number one, and two, how to negotiate it, three, what to look for. Because there's things, I get people that call me daily, I swear to you daily, that go, oh my gosh, Ben, I bought this cart. My health inspector won't approve it because he used hamster water tubing to run the gas lines. I show you all this stuff to look for and ask for when you go to look at a used cart. Because I believe in buying used carts when you can get them, right? But I tell you how to get them at the best price. That's all over there. In fact, you can go to learnhotdogs.com/used, and I've got a video that talks about what to do before you go look at a used cart. I do want to tell you all today, you know what I'm going to do? Since we got about 14 people watching, I think, if my numbers are right, 14 live, let's give away a hat. I'm going to send somebody a hat, a free hat. It's a Street Food Pro hat. I'm going to send it free. Heather, just pick me a name of somebody, or comment in the bottom if you want a hat. Comment if you want a hat. I'm going to send you a... I'm gonna let Heather pick somebody that commented, and we're gonna send you a hat. It says Street Food Pro. It's triple embroidered. It's gorgeous, right? I should have one on right now because I shaved. See, I got hair growing everywhere, but it's in patches. So here's something else I want to tell you to do. If you are just starting out, you're watching this video and going, oh my gosh, I want to do this, but I don't have a lot of money and times are tough or whatever. I know that feeling. Don't be embarrassed by it. That's 90% of us when we start now. I would go to learnhotdogs.com/2day. Heather, if you don't care to put that down below, learnhotdogs.com/2day. Okay. I have something cool there. I have taken a course that has been my second most sold course, discounted the heck out of it. Okay. Less than 10 bucks. But then on top of it, I'm going to give you a new course that I haven't even released. Free. Absolutely free. So check that out if you get a chance. It's just, you'll get to watch a video and see me, you know, in all my glory talk about it. So check that out. Amber, great question though. Thanks for asking. Let me scroll down here. Matt says, he asks about cream cheese squirter. How would you load this cream? Oh, the cream cheese squirter I put up the other day. How do you load it? I have one. In fact, I've done a video on it, but I load mine with, it's like a teaspoon. It's a longer spoon, but now they have cream cheese that comes in a tube with a pointy thing like caulk, you know, squeeze caulk, like comes in a tube with a pointy thing on the end. You cut it and you squeeze it in. That's all I do. It's easy. And now they got it in bulk. They even have it in bags. Like Sysco has cream cheese in a bag. Okay. We have vendors that use it for sour cream. We have vendors, I'm fixing to do a video that's going to just make you happy, of something I've done for a couple years, a little more than a couple years, to a dog that is delicious as heck. I'm going to show you how to make it. I'm going to show you what I do to it, my little tip. You can make it your own by just changing it up a little bit, call it your own. I did the same thing. Okay. So that's how I do that. You can soften the cream cheese if it's really, really cold, thick cream cheese. May want to bring it down temperature. Don't like put it in the microwave. Just set it on the counter for a little bit. They usually come in big blocks. You can buy already softened cream cheese. Comes in a bag. Let's see. I had another question, I think. I got to hurry because I got to start this other one and I got to prep for it. Stay tuned because at 4 today, here in 12 minutes, I'm going to be live with Candace, a vendor, a street food pro from Vendors United. She's going to talk to us, answer questions, and we're going to do that. It won't take long. We're just going to run through some questions. If you have questions for her, you can ask them. Let's see. Okay, John, I hope I pronounced this right. Dune or done? John. You know what? I have a cool. I don't know why I'm not using this. Here's the winner. John Dunne. There. That's who won. That's who won the hat. Thank you. If you will email vendors support at vendorsunited.com. support@vendorsunited.com. We'll give us your address and phone number. We'll send that. I don't even need your phone number. Give me your address. Send the hat out immediately. Okay. Jason says, what are people using to get dirty water grease stains out of their uniform shirts? A problem faced by people since people existed. Grease is a pain in the neck unless you grab it quick. Now they're making this nanotechnology shirts that don't even take, they resist stains completely. I mean, they've got some shirts that feel like this, feel like cotton, but they are, I'm representing today. I don't know if y'all saw that. I'm representing. Hot dog. Okay. They have a shirts that resist anything. I mean, about anything, even heat. So you can't even get them wet. I don't even know how you wash something. You can't get wet. So the deal is change either fabrics, like buy shirts made for food service because you're going to get mustard on it. You're going to get onion grease. You're going to get hot dog grease. I wear an apron. And most of my aprons, I've worn them some for the shows, just being silly. I've got one that's a man, all muscle chiseled out, which is the opposite of me, on the front. I've got one with a big hot dog on it. I've got aprons. I wear aprons. You can wear the three-pocket apron, too. A lot of people wear their own t-shirts. Buy a good t-shirt that is stain resistant, okay? And then as soon as you stain it, keep the shirt in your car so that you can change shirts. Keep it with you, okay? Because odds are you're going to stain the sucker at some point. It's good to take it off, run it under the hot water, throw it down, pre-soak it basically, so that when you get home, that will come out. The quicker you get soap on it, the best. That would be my best advice I could give you there. Let's see. I did check Skype. Let's see. Apron. John just said this. He says, I wear an apron too. Corey's listening. Y'all need to be following Corey. O-Doggies. I'm going to put that in here real quick just so y'all know who this is. Look this up on Facebook. And follow a street food pro, another one we're going to be interviewing soon. There's some cool people in this business that you can learn a lot from, and we all help each other. There's no cost to it, just getting better. Everybody gets better. John, is John the vendor of the week? John says, oh snap, I think I'm the vendor of the week. John, if you're the dog father of Idaho Falls, then you're the freaking vendor of the week. And congratulations. I'm glad you're here. Anyway, thank y'all for joining me. I'll be back in about 8 minutes for the live one-on-one with Candace, the street food pro from vendorsunited.com. And thank you for joining me. If you should have all the links in the comments or anything you need, and I hope you'll check that out. I'm going to put this up real quick before I go. Learn. I don't know why that's not letting me. Didn't let me. So anyway, okay. I'm going to do this for you. Learnhotdogs.com, and then let's see if I can get this right. I spelled something wrong. Anyway, I think this is it. I just put it in the comments. If it worked, I did. And it's today is the bottom line. I hope that learnhotdogs.com today. There you go. Go there. If you're just starting out, or you want that bonus thing and you don't have the instant vendor course, it's how to start with little to no money. And I give you, I've had people write in, I've even had them on the show. You go read the testimonials. It is mind-blowing information that I give you that will help, like things you wouldn't think of to get started without money. How to do this. And because hot dogs saved my life, I like sharing this with you. I'll be back in about 7 minutes, guys. Thanks for watching.